So throughout my research, I've looked at over 750 organizations. And of those, over 50 of them, I spent a significant amount of time inside their operation, really understanding how they execute. So in my experience, companies put a lot of energy and focus into crafting really great strategies, but fall short really in their ability to drive the execution of those strategies. In my thinking about it, the barriers fall into three categories. And so the first are real structural barriers. So just naturally people think about lack of alignment, right, between silos in an organization, if you will. It could be that your resources are in the wrong spot. It could be a technology barrier where we just don't have the right data getting to the right people at the right time. And so those are more structural barriers. The second category of barriers that I talk about is these rhythmic barriers. So they're the things that you would identify when you're kind of in your day-to-day whirlwind of activity. So a great one is just lack of consistency. Another great rhythm barrier is lack of prioritization. So it's, you know, the priority is not consistently defined throughout the organization. So people are kind of chasing down different priorities, even though they understand the goal, the day-to-day priorities aren't overly clear. The last one category is these awareness barriers, which most people think about when they think about culture. So one would be engagement. Another one can be silo mentality, or what I call protectionism, right? Where there's departments aren't willing to work together because they're very busy defending or protecting their resources. Another one is just insularity, which is just blinders, right? We're all trapped by our own experience, and coming outside of our own experience to take a look around at what other people are doing, that trapping in your own kind of mindset can be a real barrier to executing on a broader organizational initiative. The cost of execution concept really came to me in this idea that there is a drag factor. Like when these barriers build up, it's almost like I call it a drag, some people call it a headwind. And that drag factor actually costs the organization, in my research, a factor of 0.32. So some people like to think about that as 0.32 of a minute or an hour is lost in navigating these barriers, or some people might like to think about it as 0.32 cents on the dollar is lost. But this is just kind of the nonsense that we deal with as executors to navigate all these different barriers in the organization. You could be waiting for approvals or having to get buy-in from people who have competing interests. And if we could just get the job done, we would blow through and actually maybe get a return of a dollar on a dollar invested. The biggest advice I have is just to stop prescribing how people work. If leadership spent more time just getting barriers out of the way, people know how to do a good job. Organizations that are going to survive are those that are going to push the limits. This idea of sticking to the status quo is really challenging in today's competitive environment.